Now moving on to Northern Illinois, I went to Northern. Redshirted my first year, so that means I didn't play. We went 2-10. I had a bad year. It was a bad start to my college career. Had a school shooting that year. Unfortunately, six people were killed. I remember we had a major flood and we had an earthquake all in my first year of college. And I couldn't believe it. It was looking back on it now, I think it helped me develop as a man, but it was a really tough time. And I was at a school that I didn't know anybody. I was 4.5 hours away from home. It was hard. But with the strength of my family, a lot of close friends, I was able to get through and ended up the next year started for a couple years at Northern. Was okay, kind of up and down, and then again got interjected in my life. An opportune in my eyes. It was a bad time. I got hurt about 3/4 way through my sophomore year. Was having a pretty good year. Was getting better. Was seeing a lot of improvement, and I really tore up my knee pretty bad. And I believe it was the lifestyle I was living was not the way God wanted me to. Whether that be partying or just being a bad influence, kind of living the college lifestyle, if you will. And set me back again. So I had a brief little scope type surgery and missed 4 weeks of the season. Luckily, I was able to come back and play the last couple games of my sophomore year. Didn't play well, though. So going into my junior year now, so this was just, I believe, about 2.5 years ago, going into my junior year, I didn't even start. I got benched before the season started. So I'm going into the season. My junior year in college, I was a 2-year starter. I don't even get to start. I get benched by the backup at the time. And again, here's a guy that, my dreams are to play in the NFL. I think I'm going to play. And now all of a sudden, they're being crushed before my eyes. Because how can a kid be a backup quarterback in the MAC conference at Northern Illinois, a school that a lot of people just quite frankly hadn't heard of? How can he make the NFL? And I was thinking that. And I remember calling my father one day and I said, Dad, I don't know if I can continue to play this game. I just felt like I was being disrespected by my coaching staff and being let down. I'm like, I think I'm going to quit. I think I'm going to give it up if things continue to go this way. Push came to shove. The quarterback didn't play very well. That was in front of me. And the first game of the season, next game, I get the start, the rest is history. We won 10 of the next 11 games. The next year we won 11 games. We go to a couple bowl games. We go to a couple MAC championships and great things happen. And I believe, again, God was doing some wonderful things in my life to give me these blessings, to set me up for the platform where I was going. And I didn't know it at the time, but I didn't know what God's plan was. I didn't know what his purpose was. And part of me still doesn't know, but I think I'm starting to figure it out. I think he was trying to push me to a place where maybe I'm at right now. Maybe speaking to young kids, to people out there about, what he's done in my life. So now, I'm done with college football. And luckily, I was able to finish out strong, had a couple great years, getting ready for the NFL draft. And it's the most unbelievable process. You're training 7 days a week. We're not allowed to eat any carbohydrates, which I love bread. Our family, we eat all kind of baked potatoes. We're a meat and potatoes family. So, we're on this strict diet. We're training all the time, getting ready for the NFL draft. I remember someone asking me, where do you want to get drafted to if you get drafted? I said, anywhere but the Indianapolis Colts. And I mean that in the best way, because I say that because I just felt like there would be a lot of extra pressure, a lot of stress from family and friends, people coming to games, wanting tickets, and all those kind of things, just naturally thinking that. So draft day comes around, and I was kind of projected as a mid-level draft pick to a late-round draft pick, and the fourth round hits, the fifth round, the sixth round, I'm not getting my name called. The seventh round hits, I'm not getting my name called, all the way till the end. And then finally there, the last pick of the draft, I get the phone call. I get a call from a secretary at the Colts office says, is this Chandler Harnish? She said, yes, it is. She's like, hold for 1 second. I'm going to connect you with our general manager. And this is right when you're watching the NFL draft. The Colts are on the clock. I think it's only 2 minutes. They're on the clock. And Mr. Grigson, the GM, comes on the phone and says, Chandler, would you like to be an Indianapolis Colt? And I said, heck yes. I didn't know what I was getting myself into at the time. But really what makes that moment so exciting was I was there with some of my closest family and friends. One regret I do have is my parents weren't there. Parents and grandparents, because all the cousins and friends, we all went out golfing that day, and then the phone call came in, and it was one of those experiences you'll never forget. So I get drafted by the Indianapolis Colts, last pick of the draft, Mr. Irrelevant. Never thought, you know, what would come from that. It was so funny how people, you know, make jokes about it and all this kind of stuff. But I tell people, there's a lot of college players out there that would love just to be drafted. And I was so fortunate, so blessed. I believe it was a blessing from God that he had put me in a place that would help me do what I wanted to do for the greater good, for what he had planned for me. And it was so ironic that the team I go to, the quarterback coach who I spend most of my time with, is a devout Christian. And he is open about it. And the backup quarterback, the guy that's my mentor, his name's Drew Stanton, devout Christian. It's just unbelievable. I mean, there's no irony here whatsoever. I mean, these are God's divine plan, put me in places, and it's so obvious, and you can't not see that. And I've been so blessed.